it does not require fresh water, it does not require big space, and it does not also require fertilizer and pesticides.
It grows faster than any plant, so it takes up carbon incredibly quickly.
This will replace the heavy use of fossil fuel.
This will have a huge impact on our food production, productivity, and our soil health.
It may well turn out to be one of the most important natural resources that we have, and its capacity for climate change mitigation is unparalleled.
It's been quietly thriving for billions of years, shaped by tides, powered by sunlight, and hidden in plain sight. Not grown in fields or forests, but something else entirely. Now it's being reimagined as food, as fuel, as a climate solution. This is seaweed. Plastic and the ocean usually don't make a great mix, but seaweed could actually be the key to replacing plastic. It can be turned into compostable films, coatings, and packaging, and even edible sachets.
Seaweed is such an exciting material to work with because it has some of the properties that plastic has, such as the fact that it's flexible, it's really light, it's transparent.
So this is the Nopla solution. It's 100% natural and seaweed-based material that we use to make our OHO product. And this is basically a replica of what happens on the machine. We get a little film, a little spray, wait a few seconds, and then we'll get a little seaweed membrane, which looks a little like this.
There's over 12,000 species of seaweed, and they have a lot of genetic diversity. So some of the differences between some red seaweed and some green seaweed is wider than the difference between a mushroom and a bear. So that just shows you like how different these things are.
Depending on where it's grown, it can have different properties. So that again gives you a whole wealth of different chemistries to play with.
What is great about them is that they really behave in a similar way to what an orange peel, for example, would, disappearing completely in a few days and leaving no traces behind, and neither of microplastics.
Obviously, seaweed hits all the boxes for us when it comes to sustainability credentials. The future is bright for seaweed.
Seaweed-based packaging, like Nopla's, degrades in weeks, even in marine environments. In contrast, conventional plastics can take centuries to degrade and often fragment into microplastics, which persist indefinitely in ecosystems, circulating through air, soil, and water, and bioaccumulating throughout the food chain. Seaweed isn't just great for packaging, it's great food. Rich in iodine, omega-3s, protein, iron and fibre, it's already a staple in many Asian diets. Now it's being explored as a mainstream sustainable crop.
The main advantage of ocean-based products over traditional crops is that we don't compete with where we grow our food. So our food is grown on the coastal region. We can now have a new coastal ocean where we can grow all of these kelps and seaweed products, that there's no competition. We can feed 9 billion people if we start using protein from micro and macroalgae.
One of the most remarkable applications? Livestock feed. Adding just 0.2% of a red seaweed species, Asparagopsis taxiformis, to cattle diet can cut methane emissions by up to 90%.
So Asparagopsis is a seaweed that's been grown around the world. It was started in Australia, that is used for mitigating methane emission from cattle. So we grow the seaweed in the coastal ocean, feed it to the cattle make less methane emissions. And this is going to help us with climate change.
If scaled, this one solution could dramatically reduce emissions from the global livestock industry, which contributes around 14% of global greenhouse gas emissions. Seaweed isn't just great to grow, it's great for growth. When processed into fertiliser, kelp helps restore degraded soil, improve water retention, and reduce reliance on synthetic inputs.
In the coming decades, kelp may well turn out to be one of the most important natural resources that we have.
Seaweed cultivation offers a really exciting new food production system, both as a nutritious vegetable, but also in a number of brilliant sustainable products, including natural fertiliser. Our kelp fertiliser is an incredible soil regeneration product. It is really important that it is used alongside synthetic fertilisers to ensure that the damage that they can do to our soils is rectified.
Over the past few decades, farmers have developed a reliance on inorganic fertilisers. Inorganic fertilisers strip life from the soil, and they also reduce their ability to store carbon, retain nutrients, and keep a hold of water. Food and products grow in size, but reduce in nutritional value. Kelp fertilizer should help mitigate this.
By cultivating kelp for both food and fertilizer production, we are taking pressure off of land-based agricultural systems. This will have a huge impact on our food production productivity and our soil health. By getting it onto people's plates and into our soils, we can really show how exciting it is as a sustainable product of the future.
Seaweed farms work like underwater forests. They shelter biodiversity, restore marine life, and even protect coastlines from the impacts of climate change.
In the coastlines, in the smaller islands, so these are the most vulnerable communities to the impacts of climate change and biodiversity loss.
Sustainable seaweed farming can help fishers adapt to climate change by buffering declines in overexploited fish stocks, by helping to reduce the effects of ocean acidification and deoxygenation, and also by helping to diversify livelihoods.
Resilience in these communities is very important. Regenerative farming is helping secure sustainable sources of livelihoods for communities as a mechanism for restoring degraded marine ecosystems to ensure that these coastal communities are really prepared, really have the capability to recover or at the very least survive after the impacts of climate change. We have experienced declines in fish catch over the last few decades. So when people are completely or heavily dependent on fishing for their livelihood, then that's a very bad. So there must be something else that's trying to supplement the smaller income that people are now getting from fishing.
Seaweed can also act like a natural seawall, softening the blow of storm surges and protecting shorelines from erosion, an increasingly urgent need in the face of rising sea levels. Seaweed can not only increase resilience in the face of changing climates, it may also help reduce the rate of change. How? By sequestering carbon.
Oceans can play a really important part in the circular bioeconomy because we can capture CO2 from the atmosphere, grow it in a kelp or a seaweed, and then make products that we use in our society.
Seaweed is very effective at storing carbon because it grows faster than any plant, so it takes up carbon incredibly quickly.
Globally, ocean plants already absorb around 25% of human CO2 emissions. Seaweed could take that further, because unlike trees, some seaweed naturally sinks to the deep sea when it dies, locking away carbon. That's why researchers are exploring ocean afforestation, large-scale seaweed farming to actively remove carbon from the atmosphere. And one startup, Seaweed Generation, is already putting that theory into practice. The company is building robots that sink invasive sargassum seaweed into the deep ocean. The idea? Capture carbon from the atmosphere and store it away for hundreds of years below 1,000 meters, where it won't re-enter the climate cycle. It's early stage climate tech, but if scaled, it could help to lock away billions of tons of CO2 while cleaning up the beaches affected by harmful sargassum blooms.
Seaweed is fed naturally by nutrient-rich waters. We monitor the farm daily, weekly. We go out to the farm on the boat and check the lines on which the kelp grows. To harvest the seaweed, we winch the lines onto our harvesting vessel. We travel along the vessel and we cut or strip the kelp from the lines into buckets, which then go ashore. From seeding to harvest to first harvest would be somewhere in the region of 6 weeks. We're constantly amazed by the biodiversity in our farms. The sheer diversity of species is really incredible. So that really brings a focus onto how important seaweed cultivation is for the marine environment in general. I think seaweed has a big role to play in the regenerative farming practices.
From carbon removal to coastal protection, from fertiliser to fashion, from food to films to feed, seaweed isn't just a miracle material, it's a system solution. And this is only just the beginning.
There are exciting research and development being done in the area of other future applications of seaweeds. There are also research being done in the area of biofuels. So eventually, this will replace the heavy use of fossil fuels, no? Which probably could be a decisive factor in relation to our quest for alternative fuels. No? If you want to veer away from the petrochemical base materials, which are actually reinforcing the heating of the earth, then we have a good chance of saving the planet.
We have the science. We have the coastlines. Now we need investment, innovation, and urgency.
The future is bright for seaweed.